What do you want me to read? I'll read the beginning.
Sure. But can I ask you a question first before
you
start?
Yeah, of course.
You can hold your book there. What is story?
What is story? I think it's voice.
Voice.
I do. People would say action. People would say plot or momentum. I think a story is held together by the authenticity of the voice.
I'm headed upstate for Adrian's wedding. I'm super excited about that. And right after that, though, there is a book event in the Catskills for this girl named Stephanie Danler. She's the author of Sweet Bitter. Stephanie and I went to college together. I don't think Stephanie and I have any reason to remember each other from college. I lost my job my senior year in college, and I had to take a job as a barista at a cafe called The Middle Ground, but it was next to the bookstore in town, about like one block away. And I remember bumping into her there one time. I remember because she was the only other student I knew who would go through the poetry section of the bookstore. And then some friends of mine had creative writing class with her, and they kept passing around this story of hers, and it wasn't because of like what happened and there was no like cute boy in it or like adventurous thing. They were passing it around because of the way she put words on the page, and I realized then that like most people take creative writing to be told they're so wonderful or they have such great stories or something. She was in creative writing class to learn how to be greater. When my friends started passing around that page, I started thinking like, wow, well, here is someone who is a little more ambitious than she lets on. So it's not like she's gonna remember me from that, unless she like remembers me as like, yeah, I remember you were the guy from the coffee shop. Not only did we go to college together, we went to the same creative writing program, and then we both graduated and went to the same restaurant group in New York where we like just waited tables and screwed around until we figured out what we were doing. But then we both left Union Square Hospitality Group and both wrote two very different books about the service industry in the year 2006. At Kenyon, they didn't say, write what you know. They told us, know what you write. And when you read my book, or David Goodwillie's book, or John Green's, or Stephanie Danler's, or Emily Gould, you're gonna see rich detail, and you trust the storyteller so much more when you say, like, wow, this person really knows what they're talking about. It's what makes Stephanie's book really, like, every bitter waitress in the world, like, thinks she's got this great book idea in her head, but it's not the idea in your head, it's the idea you get down on paper, and it's how well you execute that. It's a story, and the story is only as good as the mechanics that come together for it. I also haven't seen Stephanie since we were in college together, which was, 12 years ago. 12.
I ran down the road, pants down to my knees, screaming, please come help me. That Canadian shaman gave a little too much to me. I'm writing a novel because it's never been done before. Oh, the first house that I saw, I wrote house up on the door, Lord, and told the people who lived there they had to get out, cause my reality is realer than yours.
You will develop a palette. A palette is a spot on your tongue where you remember, where you assign words to the textures of taste. Eating becomes a discipline, language obsessed. You will never simply eat food again.
After all that, I feel really funny because Stephanie reminded me of something, that we were baristas together at the same cafe in college.
I was a barista at Middle Ground.
Stephanie reminded me that we were baristas together there at the time. Need log hug.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I'm very proud of you. Stephanie, I'm really proud of you, and it's really fun for all of us Kenyon kids to like have one of us do something great.
Yeah, of course.
I said the visiting writer.
Oh, so did I. But Courtney Berkick was amazing visiting writer. Yep. I had Kluge twice.